Mic check, 1, 2, 1, 2. All day, day. Revlo track and loyalty. Knackers. What's up, man? Yeah, man. Still a brush licker. But before I was a brush licker, I was the Long War. And the Long War is coming to Twitch. Spiky Bits TV. Happening. Long War Network. Engage. Tie winning. Squatching time. See Mac. What's up, player? Legendary tablet status. And the hizzy. Wouter Van Assel, don't. The Huff. Player J, what's up, girl? Oh man, Discourager checking in. Yeah, guys, I mean, we'll be making some announcements on the show. We'll cover some of the new things that are happening. Warhammer TV. They're going to be starting, they're going to be doing 3 streams a week, I think is what they said. They did some stuff last weekend, so that's a big deal. That's kind of lit a fire under the slow rolling of the Spiky Bits TV channel. So Rob is like, nah, not today. So Spiky Bits TV is rolling out super fast now. We're on the fast track, but we're building up the network the way we need to because the Long War is a video network. And it's a conglomerate of Next Level Painting, Spiky Bits, and along with Battle Reports. So, you know, we're just reporting that over to Twitch now. Bringing that hobby content live, that hobby network, share everything. So obviously we dropped that Facebook intel today, starting to build a group around it. Basically a place for everybody who is bringing hobby back to let everyone know how they're doing it. Share their blogs, share their pictures, share their Twitch channels, their YouTube channels, their videos, their podcasts. Let's get it going. Yeah, you crazy Canadians. Canada forgot how time worked. Pothos UK, the largest man who watches our stream regularly. Unless Justin Troop is here, probably. And teabagger, so my man, just doing what you do. You know, totally Cyber Monday slipped my mind. I literally didn't buy anything yesterday. Fuck that up, Discourager. Killing Tom Payton checking in. What's up, man? Just today, not five minutes before we started streaming. 99% of the mail list went out today, for the month. We've been sending things out, staggering them as we get them with our new shipping operation, but pretty much everything that's been redeemed just went out today, with the exception of just a few packages. Some of the big, more clutch stuff that I'm packaging more carefully, more baller. Expect all your shit soon, guys. Charles Clausen, what's up, brother? Old schooler. Cheesy honey, picking up a 40 again? Oh, 40K. Warhammer. Warhammer's not dead. Age of Sigmar is popping off, brother. People love that game. I mean, like, old fantasy is dead. Literally. Does not exist. No, AOS is dope, bro. Like, I mean, they were missing some key things, like that, you know, the General's Handbook came out and really, that really brought it back. But, I mean, it's a great game system. People don't give it enough credit. There's a few things I don't like about it, but there's about 50 things I don't like about 40K. It doesn't stop me from playing it all day, every day. Dungeon Master Brad. Sup, dog?
Let's do it!
You guys know what time it is, right? Squanching time. Next level painting. Oh my god. On the dot. On the dot.
Hey yo.
On the dot. My man Slow Fuse Gaming and Gentastic, the legendary combo. Gen paints. Jason just stands around.
I just look good, baby.
That's all it is.
I'm just here for the looks. That's it.
Oh my god. And you literally stand around now, from what I understand.
Yeah. I literally stand around, and I guarantee I didn't even sit once during the stream today. And I gotta tell you, I have not felt this good at the end of a stream in a long time. Like, solid, dude. It's awesome. Awesome.
Standing's good. I'm too obese to stand all day, though.
didn't think I was going to make it. I got to be honest with you. I have my chair sitting here at the ready, but I didn't have to pull it up because I got this really nice cushion that I'm standing on. It's actually meant as a
cushion. Oh yeah, those are clutch. I need to see. That's the Cat Command Center in the Fayetteville Beats Lab. That's how it's set up.
Nice.
So we need to get some of that.
Cat Command. We have to go visit Cat Command.
Yep.
That sounds fantastic. Dude, we had the absolute blast of all blasts. Everybody coming over to Kenny's. I hope you guys had as much fun as I did. Everybody that's sitting in Kenny's that didn't join us, what the heck with you? I can't even believe it. We had so much fun.
You
gotta make sure you stop by. Tons and tons of things, man. It was great. Great! Oh, and dude, we gave away Yo-Dogs.
Did somebody get the Yo-Dogs?
Oh, yeah. Yep. They won your Yo-Dogs. Who was it?
Yeah. It was... Howdy!
Motherfucking Howdy won the goddamn Yo-Dogs.
Yep, you won 500 Yo-Dogs, bro. Literally, first day on the wheel, and we were all joking. I was like, yeah, nobody will win that shit. And they popped it. They literally popped the Yo-Dogs. Second spin of the wheel out of three tonight.
It's a good day to win the Yo-Dogs because it's the last day of Yo-Dogs. So now
I was going to say, dude, this was the time, dude. He can use it. Get into the Revlo store. Hype that shit up. Yep. Great. Great stuff, man.
It's gonna get real. I'll have Ironheaded add those 500 Yo-Dogs in here in a minute, and we'll get this bitch started. We got a lot to talk about today, because obviously, about 500-600 people saw something happen on Facebook today. So,
I think a couple of people might have seen that. A couple of people might have seen some big news. Well, we're gonna get at it, dude. I love you. We're gonna drop into this chat, blow it up for a bit. We're gonna watch you with all the intent of, like, you know, crazy fans, and then we're gonna
friends. I don't have fans. I have friends.
No, dude, I'm a fan. I'm like that fangirl that, like, screams and takes my top off.
Just you.
It gets uncomfortable around here. Like, Jen's always weird. Jen's always like, that's a little weird. I'm not gonna lie. It's a little weird. And I'm just like, shut up, he's my man.
Well, hell yeah.
I tend not to get jealous, but, you know.
All right, we're out of here. We'll catch you.
Thanks. Stop by. Love you guys.
Yeah. Bye.
All right, you guys obviously know who Slow Fuse Gaming is. And Gentaz, thanks for turning it over to me. Today is Tuesday, which is quickly becoming the new literal best of all days. It is a giveaway. It's the last t-shirt that we have, guys. It's literally it. Exclamation point giveaway. Get the details on that. It is a top donator giveaway. It's a 3XL big boy shirt. So I apologize for all the regular human-sized individuals out there. That shirt's probably too big for you. I mean, it's even a little big for me. I'd have to cut the sleeves off just to make it not look ridiculous. But that's what we got, guys. As usual, the winner of this t-shirt can have me personalize it if they wish. My man Oz Pete got one personalized. Literally, it's up to you. Shit's going to get real today, guys. Obviously, the big news is the Long War Network is coming to Twitch. All right? The stream team is already on the website or on Twitch. It's in a... kind of we have in a little bit of a dormant state right now. This doesn't mean we're leaving Breastlickers United. Doesn't mean we're not members of Blue. It just means the Long War is coming to Twitch. And the Long War is a video network. It is a conglomerate of Spiky Bits, Next Level Painting, and the Long War Battle Reports. It is now has a Facebook group. And the whole purpose of the group is for everyone to share their podcasts, their, you know, your YouTube channels, their Twitch channels, their work in progress, everything, literally about bringing hobby back, bringing the community together. It is a network. Spiky Bits TV is on the horizon. Basically, Rob woke up and saw Warhammer TV, said, we're going to do three things a week starting the 15th of December. Rob immediately calls me. He's like, no, not today. We got to get online. He's been procrastinating. We procrastinate no longer. The Long War Network has a Facebook group, has a stream team. Spiky Bits TV is about to go live. It's going to be at the beginning, it's going to be a Monday news show. And then it's going to, with an expansion to hobby, it's going to be covering a lot of the stuff that's been happening. And we're going to be doing a lot more interaction. We're going to blow the fucking lid off the hobby. So big shout out to all you guys. My man, Leona Lopez, thanks for the 25 cheer. Let's talk about it, guys, real quick. Trying a new little segment out here. So obviously we talked about the shirt. Let's talk about fucking out of graphic. There it is. That was supposed to be on when I was talking about the Long War Network. So far the Long War Network is gonna be Next Level Painting, Spiky Bits, and Slow Fuse Gaming. And we will expand into the Long War TV eventually. We gotta make leaps and bounds as we go through here. But obviously, new battle report. You guys have entered the Long War. You know about this. We got Tau versus Warcon. This is a fucking amazing game. My man A-Dog Austin versus Juice. These models are on point. You're not going to want to miss that. Let's jump into the money shot, guys. Oh my god, what is that? All right. I know there's tons of questions. I'll jump into those in here in 1 second. Oh, my man Yori Casudon checking in. My man Cancor, thanks for becoming a legend and subbing to the channel. And I think I missed one earlier. My man Assassin in Red, thanks, brother. Yori, welcome back. So, this is the base we worked on last week, guys. And I'm only going to show it off a little bit here. Real quick at the beginning, then I'll take some Q&A, and then we'll talk about what we're going to cover today. But I wanted to show you guys the base that it was done. It is the Everqueen, and as you guys have been following, Musefi, what's up, brother? Legend, one of the iciest individuals I know. I'm just putting the gloves on because I don't like fucking with it without my gloves on. Okay. Oz Pete, legend. Okay, so here we go. Here's the Beetle in its glory. And so this is the Everqueen. And if you guys have been following the theme of our Tree Person's Army, it's about all the different seasons of the groves. And the Everqueen is supposed to be tying in all the seasons. So the theme of the base is that she's essentially melting away the snow with her righteousness and causing the seasons to all swirl together at once. Like trees growing leaves, leaves falling off, green grass shooting through the snow, and flowers, and then, you know, just gangster. We've even used that secret weapon, snow. I don't know if I can show it on camera too well, but it is in the channels in there. It is basically melted snow. You can see it's how it's running off against the rocks and melting away. Basically using that super realistic crushed glass. Get that slush. It's basically what we're going with here. And this is just a classic example, guys, of just using the right materials, man, to get this kind of effect. Normally, I wouldn't put all this type of different base and supplies on one base. That's kind of crazy. But that's the theme of our army. And she is all of all seasons. And of course, we finally finished painting that bug's ass. So I'm going to turn the light down so you can see it a little bit. We got that orange in there underneath her undercarriage, so she's kind of got that exciting color. And there it is. This is done. We're gonna call this done. We gotta paint the girl herself. Son of Bjorn, thanks, my brother. This is the definition of go nuts right here, guys. This is. Moonman, goodbye.
Shut the f*** up about Moon Men!
Borax coming in hot, throwing $10 down. You keep it icy. He is on the board. He's the first man. He's getting those Yo Dogs, and also, he's top donator to get that shirt. Is my man Ironheaded checking in yet? Where is Ironheaded at? I've not seen that fool. Ironheaded, if you're checking in, my man Howdy has 500 Yo Dogs. He won them today over on Slow Fuse Gaming on the wheel. Okay. So, we went nuts. This is done. So, obviously, we've got to paint the Everqueen herself. And this is where we left off last time we were working on her. I have done a bunch of basting over the last few days, and I'll show some more of that off. But the Everqueen, we blocked in her colors. And today, we're going to experiment with some of this and bring it out. This purple robe is going to be cherry blossom pink. It's going to be, you know, fade into a cherry blossom pink. All like on these scattered leaves. We're gonna do some crossfade icy blue on that blade. We're gonna put some yellows in on these armor pieces. Just bring the gangsterness here, you know. Commander Kino, I appreciate that, brother. Leonardo Lopez dropping cheers like it's hot. Major Dodo, you got your gift bag today. Your hand stuck to the bag because it was so icy. Major Dodo, didn't I give you that for just being ridiculous one time? All right. And last of all, This will be a top donor to giveaway soon enough, guys. Thanks to your guys' help. Here is our Alpha Legion Tribune, Praetor Tribune, special edition from Forge World. If you guys didn't follow along, we actually on Twitch, we built this color scheme together. You guys made this blade happen. And then on Patreon right now still is how to paint the scales on this shoulder pad. And thanks to you guys, this came to life. If it wasn't for you guys, I never would have painted it this way. Super happy about this. So let me put this down, and let me jump into Q&A, because a lot of people ask a lot of questions, and I haven't gotten to them. And I feel like that's half the show. Communication. Let me see what's going on here. Scroll up to the Tizop. Manforge Zen Z. Hashtag. Long war dropping bombshells. Yori. Been a while since I managed to catch a full live stream. Dog, I miss you, homie. Where you been? I know you probably got real life. Fucking real life is the worst. Genuine, what's up, brother? Happy fake Wednesday, you weirdos. Viking Teabagger, I really appreciate it. Do what I can, man. Hoodsgate, we're going to be painting the Alariel herself. Assassin in Red is all one word. Assassin Red. Assassin Red. Got it. And where the fuck is Ironheaded? Is he not here? God damn it. What a ridiculous person. Is Howdy in the house? Yeah, he is. Let me see if I can't throw you a bonus real quick, Howdy. My man Howdy just picked up some Yo Dogs from Slow Fuse Gaming. I want to make sure he gets them right now. I think we got them. Yep, you got some coin, homie. Don't spend it all in one place. Valkyrie, what's up, girl? Keeping it icy. Axelin, what's up? Doing what we can, brother. LT, legend. So many Yo Dogs, so little time. Just spend them. What are you waiting for? Just go in there and say, I want this shit. You're rich. You're Yo Dog rich. All right. Let me bang out a quick text. Make sure Ironheaded didn't fall asleep. We're getting, shit's getting real. My man Borax, thanks, brother. Where you at, dog? Oh, it's gonna get real, homie. There it is. And his name is John C. Shit's getting real. Sal Doc is on the board. He says, this shirt's too small. It's a 3XL, full disclosure, guys. Trying to take it home today. Getting those Yo Dogs. And, of course, my man LT just picked up some swag, legendary swag. If Ironheaded doesn't make the show, guys, Yo Dogs will not be updated in real time via donation to the store. I'll do it at the end of the stream. That's just how it works when he's not here. But everything else is going to track, so you're going to be fine. And I'm going to give you guys literally until the end of business tomorrow to cash your Yo Dogs out in the Revelo store. So it's not going to just go down tonight. You'll have literally until tomorrow, 1:32 in the morning when I remember. Mr. Handsome Dan, what's up, my man? We're about to do this thing. Thanks for jumping in, brother. Got people dropping cheer bombs, and it's time to get swifty. I'm gonna keep my celly handy, see where Ironheaded is. Hopefully he's okay. And let's start it. Let's talk about the Everqueen. So Oz Pete just filling the cup. I'm going to ask you guys first what we should start on. So we've got a couple things that you've seen me do before and you haven't seen me do probably yet. I don't know. So do you want to see me? Do you want to see me try to keep? Want to see me make this blade icy? Do you want to see me make this cloak pink? Those are the two things that you have to pick right now. Give me an at next level painting so I see it, and say icy or pink. That simple. And I'm going to figure out which one we're going to start off on. And while you guys are doing that, I'm going to get my gloves on. Icy or pink, guys? That next level painting, give me the ice or give me the pink. That's good. Got a lot of movement in the chat. Let me look. A lot of icies. A lot of pinks. Looks like icy is crushing, though. Okay, looks like we're going to keep it icy. So much ice. Is it split? Is it? Because it looks like a lot of ice. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Looks like 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Son of Bjorn, fishing for the gangsta cats. Keep it icy, brother. Do what you do. Get those yo dogs. What does it look like, guys? Is it ice or is it pink? Looks like ice to me. One, two. Normally I have Ironhead to do all this. Where's he at? Three. Four, five, six. Seeing like three times as many ices as pinks. All right, we're gonna. How about this? Can we agree to these terms? That if I just that I'll roll a dice on it. How about that? It's so split that maybe we should just leave it in the hands of some dice rolling. What do you guys think? I'm sliding over here to get my dice. All right. There it is. We got a couple casino dice in here. Oh, we can make it a roll off instead of a D3. How about that? We'll say casino dice is ice because you always keep it icy with casino dice. And we'll say the regular dice is pink. High roll wins, guys. This is how we're going to do it. Dice is not what the hobby is about. All right. You heard it? Casino dice is ice. Oh, we got trashed. Motherfucking pink just ruined our icy asses. All right, we're painting pink, guys. That simple. Let's get it going. Easy enough. Yo, Swish, I've been using those dice for years. They're probably beat up now. Okay. Valkyrie and the Hizzy. It's my girl right there. Big shout out, $40 donation, getting all the Yo Dogs. She says thanks. Pushing that skill level. I'll do what I can. Do what I can. And you're the top donor. You're about to go home with a 3XL t-shirt. Always bet on pink. Icy should have a reroll. It's true. Okay, so we started off with this right here. This is that royal purple. We've got this other not royal purple. We've got this magenta too, and we've got this pink. These are the colors I'm going to try to incorporate into this. Big shout out to my girl Valkyrie right there. She holds it down. And it's time to do a little bit of paintbrushing, guys, before we yank the airbrush out of its slumber. Devil Man, keep it icy, brother. So we're going to pull this regular purple out. I think there's purple in here. Yeah, there's purple in here. Just got it all over my base brush. No! Where the fuck is my water? There we go. Yeah, I'm gonna do it. It's accurate, right? Not royal purple. I'm gonna squirt a little water in here. I'm gonna shake it up. See what happens. There we go. So we got not royal purple. Royal purple. And we're gonna start with this. So what we're going to do is, you definitely know we're going to combo the airbrush off on this robe. But before we get there, we're going to definitely do a little paintbrush work first so we can incorporate the two. Paintbrush is how I get, I'll get those clean lines of the paintbrush, kind of figure everything out, and then I'll come in and just blast them out with the airbrush and get those like perfect flared out tips. All right, so what I'm going to do first is I'm just basically going to mix some of the not royal purple in with the royal purple. And we're just going to come back over here and just give it a thin coat right back over what we've done. So the dark-ass royal purple is our base coat. And now this is like just a couple notches brighter. Just a little bit brighter. And this is more exploratory than anything. We're mainly just, you know, seeing how we feel about that first stage. Let's turn the light up a little bit. Okay. And I feel pretty good about that. So now we're going to leave the inner cloak still dark, though. I like that. Eh, maybe not. I might sneak around now that I'm looking at it. We're going to brighten it up. See that? And this is just thinned down, just using a big old base brush. And this part is kind of annoying. Like, I left as many pieces off this model as I felt comfortable with. So, you don't get, you know, it's a big model, thankfully. so it's not so bad to get down in these spots. But it'd be so nice if I could leave like this leg off or this front cock robe off. That simple. So that's like 1 degree brighter. Is Iron Headed back? Iron Headed! Oh my god, he's back! During the first show and tell break, I'll catch Iron Headed up on Yo Dogs. I already updated Howdy's for winning the wheel. Iron Headed, I miss you, dog. Where you been? I can't do this without you, man. Okay, so you see, when you're working with a color that you're making just a couple shades above your color, that your base color, it just goes on easy. Like, the stick is there. Because it's almost the same color, you know? And so that means you can go on very thin. And I'm not going to fucking, with the headpiece, with this big brush, I'm going to switch brushes for that. But I'm going to switch it back to the big surface area back here. Don't call it a comeback. I've been here for years. Okay. So we're gonna do a nice thin coat over all this bullshit. And we'll be able to get away with a lot of airbrushing in the back of the cloak. So we don't have to go, we're not going to go too crazy back here because the airbrush is going to get it done for us. So just a nice even coat. I just don't want the airbrush to have to also apply the paint. I want it to just apply the feathered out fades. Like, I'm past bake, I'm not base coating with the airbrush at this stage. You know what I mean? We're augmenting. We just did a video on that actually, guys. Part 2 of painting the Damasheron, the Tyranids. The whole theme of that episode on YouTube, on Twitch, sorry, on Patreon, is how to use your paintbrush and your airbrush as tools together. How I'm painting this a certain way, knowing I'm going to use the airbrush as I come back in. Okay, that's almost dry enough for the second pass. So I'm just going to clean off the base brush real quick and grab a smaller brush. Oh, people are redeeming. And we're going to come in here with that smaller brush and just catch the cowl around her face. Just nice and watered down. Commander Kino, dog. Thanks for stopping by, brother. Miss you, homie. It's like a hair stuck to the model right there. Get that shit out of here. Alright, just a quick layer. Axlan. Ask Kit, do you know about a streaming group that does kit bashing? I think everyone does. That's my main man right there. Charles Clausing, yo, $5 donation, getting those Yo Dogs. Thanks, brother. Yo, man, literally, I'm so glad you found us, brother. Ain't even like that, homie. Appreciate it. Okay, so now we're bringing out a little bit brighter. This is the not Royal Purple, mixing with a little bit of Royal Purple. And we're just going to come on quick. Just like that. Same protocol, guys. It's nice and thin. We're going to definitely sneak our airbrush in on this. It's going to be glorious. Orc Pride, exclamation points redeem. You'll be able to find the store link. Just like that. The trick, definitely, if you're, you know, if you like to combo your airbrush off and you want to be smooth, these thin coats are really how you make your paintbrushing, you know, texture similar to your airbrush texture. Because the last thing you want is to have some clean airbrush skin and then have some, like, you know, textured ass fucking details. So here we go. Just thin, thin, thin. Oh, we gotta bring the small print brush in there. Sneak back in the inner cloak. It's annoying. But have it nice and watered down so it's flowing pretty easy. Boom. Just upgrading. Working our way up. We're about to pull out that air. We're gonna pull that airbrush out soon, though. Yeah, guys. I see. For the people who donated before Ironhead got here. If you can whisper him, I'll cross-reference with him when we go to our first show-and-tell break. Okay, here we go. Just adding some of that brighter purple to these end pieces right here, because I'm really going to make those crazy when we're done. Just water it down. See how it flows, and but it sticks at the same time. Blending with a brush. Motherfucker, I don't know how to use a paintbrush. Slow Fuse Gaming. I'm only doing the minimum possible before I can pull my airbrush out. Axlin, the guy who converted the bikes for me, his name is Brian Mole on Facebook. He does not have a stream, no. Okay. So we've done a few coats here, just building it up to a brighter color. Very broad and thin strokes. As you can see, paint is thin, it's almost a wash. Kind of like a glaze right now. Glazing it. These smaller areas, we're going to do more work on. But these bigger areas, we can sneak our airbrushing on. Get that hip. Hips don't lie. Okay, this is all still pretty watered down, so we're going to let that dry for a minute. And let's take the small brush out and just drop some off on this cowl. Pretty simple. Simple, but not, I mean, it's simple, but it's not like mindless. You have to pay attention when you're doing it. What's up, baby? Oh, damn. Hold on. I can't get them both. She brought me some iced tea. Thanks, baby. I need that. Yeah. Let's just get this right here, then let it dry for a minute. Back of the head piece. And this shit is just thin, man. Look at that. Because we're going to use, you know, we're going to use all manner of technique to blend it and highlight it. Okay, so we're going to let that sit for 1 second. I want all of the thin coats we just did, I want those to dry a little bit before we keep going. Looks like we got some speckling. I hate it when I do that. Looks like I was being really aggressive and I flicked some purple dots in on the wings here. Yeah, it just means we're going to have to pull the airbrush back out. Shit happens, right? Sometimes. All right. Okay, guys. I'm going to let all that dry. We're going to do a show and tell !show. Let's see what you guys are working on. I want to see what your work in progresses are. I want to see what your gallery shots are like. Tomorrow is Whip Wednesday on Slow Fuse Gaming, so people with the highest upvotes win shit. You don't want to miss that. First things first. I need a little bit of some fine aged, keeping it icy action. Valkyrie says, is Rob going to get the ear headphones for streaming? Obviously, I bought them for him, so he's going to fucking wear them. I was like, that is added to cart and sent to Rob's house immediately. All right. Oh, get some of that. Okay. Let's jump into it, guys. See what the show and tell gallery holds for us today. Handsome Dan. Dude, I want to see what you guys are working on. I don't care how good it is. You trying to downplay me? You're downplaying me. I know you are. Logging in. We're almost there. The anticipation. Whip gallery. Boom. Let's see what's going on here. Make sure to use your names, guys. If you don't use your names, I don't know how to honor you. I'm doing a quick approval real quick. Got a lot of people jumping in. This is going to be exciting. Show me what you got. Oz Pete knows what I got. Okay, I'm going to jump on Valkyrie first because this one right here doesn't say name. So here's Valkyrie, work in progress. Working on some Wolfen. Come at me, bro. Come at me, bro. Okay, let me move the ancient Chinese tablet over here so I can see what's going on. All right. That is pretty dope, Valkyrie. I must admit. And while you guys... Twinner, you excited for the Long War Devils doubles? Oh, hell yeah, bro. I'm super glad you guys are going to make it out. All right, Valkyrie, this looks amazing. Oh, am I the wrong one? Yep. JJ Newcomb in the house. Iron-headed. Tight. JJ Newcomb, tight. Did you get Iron-headed? Did you get... Did you get Borax for $10, keeping it icy? Slow Fuse Gaming. He just watched a bunch of commercials on the fucking cheer thing is what he did.
And his name is John C.
Oh my god. Okay. So, people are going crazy. My man Chikuza just dropped a 60 spot. He's the top donator to get this t-shirt. And I think he's the right size for it. Him and I, we have about the same build, me and Chikuza. And that's a 3XL shirt. So, oh my god, you one bit spamming fools. There might be a couple we missed. I don't know. I think we're caught up, though. If you guys don't think that your Yo-Dogs have been applied to your account, definitely hit up my man, Ironhead. But I think we're caught up. Just want to make sure everything is on course. Thank you for all the cheers, you crazy sons of bitches. And JJ Newcomb, you're crushing it with this. Let's jump in on Quarantine. Let's see what you got, homie. Quarantine 82. With that plasma coil, oh snap, dog. I painted a bunch of these once. Huh. Is that what you guys are doing? Is that what you guys are doing? You guys are watching the little commercials, getting your 5 bits and your 10 bits and stuff? In case you guys didn't know that, you can go into the cheering to go get bits. You can say, I want to watch an ad instead, and it'll literally give you bits for watching an ad. Twinner, are you, did you donate with a PayPal e-check? Because sometimes we miss those. Moving back. Star Sunders, Tech Priest. Let's see what you got here, man. Well, you are a... You're a scientist. The way you're painting this is very scientific. Take a look at this. Yo, that's crazy, homie. Ain't nobody got time for that. You work hard for those bits, Slow Fuse. I heard that. I heard it. Oh, Twitter. Like, literally a couple months ago, if you guys don't know, you're new. Oh, my God, it happened. Kaboom. The Yo Dogs reset every month. It is a monthly contest, guys. This is the last day of the month, or last stream of the month. The Yo Dogs are not going to reset until tomorrow in the wee hours, like tomorrow, you know, after midnight. So you have all day today to collect Yo Dogs through watching the stream. And you have all until tomorrow night to redeem on the store before I do anything with it. It is a monthly contest. Nothing rolls over. Definitely want to sign up on Twitch or go to !info, follow the link train, get me up on Twitter, hit me up on YouTube, get extra Yo Dogs that way. Yo, this is looking fresh, my brother. Let's take a look at Vaughn Badgeworth. Oh my God, I haven't seen you for a while. This is glorious. Hold up. What are you doing posting? This is makes me feel bad about painting. The Great White Buffalo, you suck! Denied. Oh, you're so awful of bits, Great White Buffalo. Saras Kane, thanks for being a legend. Keep it icy, brother. Always keeping it icy. But yeah, Bomb Badgeworth, this chaplain is on point, my man. This is ill. These litanies are so clutch. Oh, it was emote mode only for 2 minutes? Is that what happened? Did that just happen and I missed it? So that's one of our Revlo store deals. So basically you can spend Yo Dogs and the chat can only post with emotes, the sub emotes, for like 2 minutes. It's ridiculous. Oh my God. Leonid Lopez dropping 50 bits, trying to blow it up. You guys are crazy. All right, let's do a few more before we get back to it. Ilario is drying. Mr. Handsome Dan, Night Lords Raptors, work in progress. Best picture I have at the moment. Let's see. Handsome Dan. Yo, good job, my man. Night Lords. These are the OG Night Lords, or OG Raptors. Oh my God. You win a prize just for that. Oh, so I guess if you're a moderator, you can post normal words when it's emo only. Lanix, first time in the stream, seems legit. First time in the stream, if you want to get on the show and tell session, !show, take you straight to the link. We're reviewing some of the other people in the community's work while we're letting our Everqueen dry before we get back to the airbrushing right here. This is kind of how we break up the show. Welcome to the stream, my man. The cup overfloweth. Star Sunders. Don't be hating the sub assemblies. The Great Buffalo said, nah. Ooh, ooh. Bow. Okay. The Great Buffalo upped his game. I'm sorry I said you sucked at cheering. You're actually amazing at cheering. Big shout out to my man, Great White Buffalo. Doing what you can, brother. Appreciate it, homie. Devilman, let's take a look at what you're working on, homie. Oh, this looks so good. It's so realistic. Oz Pete, you spammy Australian. God. It looks like we almost triggered our Mystery Bits giveaway. Yeah, this is looking good. This Dreadnought is on point. This Dreadnought is on point. Leona Lopez. It missed half. Leona Lopez, I don't know what to say. That was depressing. Devilman, these Dreadnoughts are as glorious and realistic as I've ever seen. Low life, and let's see this dwarf you're working on. Yeah, that's right. You've been working on these. I love the sunrise, like the Key West sunrise effect. I know it's probably supposed to be molten, but it looks like a sunrise. Here comes Slow Fuse dropping the... Oh, that's how it's done. The bits are just going crazy all over me. So ridiculous. Oh, yeah, guys. And, of course, we have the $165 swag crate on the Revlo store, the raffle. 6-inch Yodog's getting on that raffle. I'll draw that winner first stream of December. So that way it always holds through. Good job, Lowlifin. You're holding it down, brother. Let's take a look at my man, Wouter Van Asseldonk's Night Titan that he's working on. Oh, it's corn. You know that makes me love it instantaneously, no matter what. I love the... See, this Beats Lab is how my Beats Lab looks. It's exactly how my Beats Lab looks. Lowlifin, well, then you chose correctly, sir. All right, let's do just a couple more. It's still a little wet in some spots. N1, the Javi 4, Alpha Legion Theater Project finally got some work done. Oh, shnikes. You know, how you feeling about the new Chaos Legions? We're going to be doing some podcasting on that shit tomorrow, guys. Oh, my God, Slow Fuse Gaming. You insane person. Tidy Beats Lab. It does look like a crime scene. Dragon, what's up? You guys, did you guys see the picture I posted on Facebook of the most legendary pumpkin cake in history? Thanks to a certain individual on this stream who dropped it off at my crib. I have already eaten 2/3 of it. Alpha Legion's looking fresh, my man. Good job, brother. Let's take a look at same dude. I don't know how to say it. Najavi. Oh, yeah. Son of Bjorn. Beats Lab upgrade. Get those $20 in Yo Dog, Son of Bjorn. Cheers. Last swallow for you. That 101 proof heist tea. Yes, Bonet ate about half of what I ate. She couldn't stop herself either. Ninja Dave. It's Ninja Dave. Of course it's Ninja Dave. Ninja Dave. Yo, Handsome Dan, thanks for joining, brother. Do what you gotta do, Holmes. Okay. These look great, brother. That's it for show and tell. Don't worry, we'll get to the rest later. There will be multiple show and tell sessions. In the meantime, I'm going to jump over to... First, let me turn this off. Check my whispers. One second. One second. And if anyone's curious about how top donation works, all bids stack. You don't have to beat your previous bid. You can literally donate a dollar. All bids stack. Thank you. Thank you, Ironheaded. Okay, guys. Let's talk about it real quick because we got a lot of people jumping in, asking questions. This is an interesting time if you're new to our stream to jump in because it is actually the last stream of the month, which means the contest is going to end today. We're almost wiped out in the Revlo Star. Looks like we have two Death Watch gift bags left. These comes with a clutch Death Watch character model from the Cassie set and resin base to match. We've also got, sorry for lip smacking, we've also got three 30k themed swag crates. These are worth $100 each. They're sourced out of Betrayal style 30k swag. And we've got four Prospero Burn swag crates sourced from Prospero Burns. You might get the custodies, you might get some of that new Airman action, who knows. So that's what's up in the Yo-Dog store right now. Of course, we have the epic raffle right here. You don't want to miss that. If you get an opportunity, you're going to want to spend all your fucking Yo-Dogs by tomorrow. So we do have a few things in here that if you want to be generous and kind of donate your Yo-Dogs back to the stream, like emote only chat, double X Yo-Dogs for 5 minutes, and of course make it rain. All right, enough about the promotion, guys. Let's paint. And Leona Lopez, you are doing it. Cheese honey, yo dog, plural. Viking teabagger into hizzy. Okay. Okay. I'm trying to think about how icy I want to get it. I want to get icy. Okay. Let's see how brave we are today, guys. I'm going to pour her over here. And we're going to pull out our airbrush. So, you guys, if you guys are old schoolers, you've seen me do this before. If you guys are brand new to the stream, we're about to do some airbrush gangster maintenance 101, right, chill? The airbrush has been sitting in its solution for a couple hours. And we are about to give it a quick scrubbing. But first, we got to find our tools. And Ironheaded is always fucking with me and moving them. That's how he does. I guarantee it's on the floor back here somewhere. God damn it. This is annoying. Why does this always happen to me? It's almost like I forget that I go live. And that I have a stream to do and a pace to maintain. So, okay, where are they? Someone tell me. I guarantee there's a Land Raider in the raffle this month. I guarantee it. You think it's in the hobo sink? I'm gonna look. Not in the hobo sink. I think I was using one of the pipe cleaners the other day. Where the fuck? How does this happen to me every time? All right, give me 1 second. They could be somewhere. Oh my God, you wouldn't believe where they were. I found them. Okay. Not in the hobo sink, I promise. Yo, thanks for becoming a legend, Jagger. Jagger A5157, legendary individual. He was right next to the iced tea. Okay, so we're going to give it a quick scrubbing, just coming straight through. Using a small one, now we're going to switch up. That simple, guys. I play it real loose with my airbrush. A lot of people revere the airbrush, like almost like they fear it. Like, it's a tool, homie. Like, it's made sturdy if you have a good airbrush. Why I always recommend buying quality shit. It's made to last. It's durable. Treat it like any kind of tool. Keep it well maintained, well oiled, and it'll do shit for you. But it's also not delicate. It's not gonna just break on you. there are just like anything, they're delicate components. Saudak, yep, that's exactly what happened. Mike, that's exactly what happens. Okay, just giving it a quick clean job. Keep the tip clean right here. And this happens sometimes when your shit gets especially dirty. The brass tip gets stuck in here. Look at how much bullshit was in there. Because I was painting a lot of shit the other day. Look at that. Great right, Buffalo in the hizzy, coming in fresh. That man's legend. Hype that man up, please, guys. All right. If you guys don't know, while I'm doing this, let me talk about something for a second. A lot of people have been asking me about that, my man. T6 Ted, am I going to paint a Magnus? I promise you I will. But I'm not going to promise you when. It's the best I can do. So a couple things are happening right now, guys. So you may have seen this online. The Long War Network is coming to Twitch. As a matter of fact, it's already here. Some people have been asking a lot of questions. What does this mean for Brushlickers United? This and that. If you guys don't know, Brushlickers United is a stream team that I'm on. You even can see right now that I'm being creative on Brushlickers United. You can be on more than one team, guys. And before I was a Brushlicker, I was a Long War veteran. And the Long War is coming to Twitch. It is going to be a network just like it is. It's a conglomerate. The Long War has always been Next Level Painting, Spiky Bits, and basically Long War Battle Reports. So now it's going to kind of be more of a network. It's going to be an exclusive clutch stream team on Twitch. It's going to cover weekly hobby news, breaking stories. It's going to cover sculpting, you know, hobbying, playing. It's going to cover airbrushing. It's going to cover everything. More coming in the future. The next big piece of that equation is that Spiky Bits TV is coming to Twitch quick. And I talked about this earlier in the stream. Basically, Warhammer TV, they set the pace. They said, hey, motherfuckers, we're going to be streaming 3 times a week next month. So that's going to influence potentially our schedules going in the future too, guys. If Warhammer TV says they want to stream the same fucking time as me, guess what I'm going to do? Not stream that time anymore. That's just insane. You know, so you may see an adjustment in schedule coming in the future, depending on what GW wants to do. They've already announced their times, and for the most part, they don't fuck with us. But that kind of lit a fire under Rob Bear, Spiky Bits' ass. Spiky Bits TV will be a Monday news show covering all manner of things in the hobby and rumors and news and breaking stories. But also, if you guys didn't know, Rob Bear is an amazing hobbyist. The motherfucker is legend. And so we have a Facebook group now, guys. You might want to check it out. It's the Long War Network. It's got about 500 people on it right now. Go over there, subscribe or follow it, whatever. Here's the big deal with it, though. This is what we want from you guys. We want you to join the group, and we want you to post. I want you to post pictures of what you're working on. I want you to post your podcasts. I want to know about your YouTube channels, and I want to know about your Twitch streams. I want to know everything about you guys, and I want the resources to be in one place, the Long War Network. I want to spread that hobby love. I want everyone to have access to it, and we're going to promote it. In the future, we are going to convert the Long War page into a more dedicated hobby resource channel. Shit's getting real, guys. We can't do it without you. All right, so we did a pretty good cleaning here, and we're going to do something you've seen me do a couple times in the past. Saudok, that is not the official drink of the goddamn Long War. That's juice and fucking probably Slow Fuse Gaming's drink. If you put milk in your liquor, I don't even know how to respond to you. All right, do you see what just happened right there? I'll just push this whole clump of paint out. If you guys don't know what I'm doing, hops number 9. This is a gun solvent. Put a little bit on the needle. And I'm just moving the needle around in here. and it's breaking up any bullshit that was left behind. Look at that.
Moon man.
Oh shit.
Goodbye, moon man.
Shut the f*** up about moon men.
My man, Werewolf, says get ready for 2X. Guys, you're about to be earning two times. Shout out to my man. $5 donation. LT, what are you guys doing with the podcast? Is the content going to be absorbed by the Twitch? No. The podcast is kind of the leader of the whole, the avant-garde, the vanguard, as it were. You'll be able to download the podcast on iTunes. You'll be able to download it the same old way. But in the future, you could see new type of webcasts. You might see a Hollywood Squares format. You might see me, Jason, Rob Bear, Juice, Mike Caspel. You might see us all up on there on Twitch. I don't know, because the Longword TV hasn't even dropped yet. We're just talking about the Longword Network. But, you know, we got a lot of things, a lot of room for improvement, a lot of things to do still. Okay. So this is an important part of cleaning the airbrush, is the trigger. T6 Ted, Rick and Morty is life. Okay? Alright. We're clear now. Okay, so now the next thing we're going to do, we're just going to drop a little bit of that oil down right here. And we're going to put said trigger in the hole. So you're going to put the long cylinder dick-shaped object in the vagina-shaped hole. Can I make it more clear what this innuendo is about? Okay, next thing we're going to do here, a little bit of that oil right here. Where did my spring roll off to? There it is. Yeah, it is Swifty. There we go. And we got a little bit of oil on this already. So here's another trick. See, watch this. I'm going to push. See this? It's pushed out right here. So I'm going to hold it open. And I'm going to put a little oil on this spot right here. That's not normally exposed, you see? Slow Fuse Gaming, you crazy son of a bitch. Son of a bitch pop monkey nuts. Okay, so now my airbrush is in what I consider ready to fucking go mode, okay? Oh my god, that's a great move right there, Wouter Van Asadonk. Okay, it's go time. Airbrush. Compressor. Engaged. Compressor is going. We're going to let it charge up. You don't want to fuck up here. We're about to be brave, guys. We're about to be brave. Yeah, sorry guys, first off, big shout out to my man Slow Fuse Gaming. He is going to be a part of the Long War Network going into the future. He is one of the most legit individuals I've ever met. Puts on one of the fucking most fabulous shows. Probably has something to do with the fact that he's been a long time broadcaster, entertainer for years on Twitch in the past on the World of Tanks. Big shout out for the cheers, my man. But we did a little airbrush maintenance there. I apologize to anybody that's old hat to. But airbrush maintenance is one of our most asked questions on YouTube, so that's why we try to cover it as often as possible. Okay, so we're about to get brave. Okay, so shit's about to get real. Guys, see what I'm doing here? All day, every day, homie. Yo, you guys don't even know. Slow Fuse Gaming is going to be playing some motherfucking 40K. He's going to be playing some new Chaos, I promise you. Oh, damn, look at that. Huh. She's about to get so gangster in here. All right, I'm just running a little bit of pure water through the airbrush right now, guys. Into the hobo sink. You guys know how I do. If you guys don't know, Adepticon. Okay, we have a weekly podcast. If you guys don't know, it's called The Long Wear. Next week, we're going to be interviewing my man Chris from Adepticon. He's one of the big cheeses that runs that event. We're going to be talking about why you want to go to Adepticon this year. First off, here's the first fucking reason. Slow Fuse Gaming, Kenny Boucher, Rob Bear, Juice, fucking Mike Haspel. We're going to all be there. You're not going to want to miss it, guys. It's going to get gangster. Also, other select members of the Brush Slickers United stream team will be there. My man Mike Cho will be there. He'll be doing some crystal brush if I know him. Tickets are on sale right now, guys, at Adepticon.org. And while I'm running a little bit of pure water through my brush, let me take this opportunity to talk about somebody who recently sent me some epic swag. Ace Case. I think it's exclamation party. Ace Case, if my man Ironheaded, if you can drop that that command for me. Exclamation point Ace Case, I believe. Let me just double check. Let me see. Is it not working? No? Let me check out the command. Oh, it's A Case. I fucked that up. It's called A Case. For some reason, I thought it was Ace Case. I fucked up. Apologize to my sponsor. They'll forgive me. There it is, guys. Check this shit out right here. This, I have this case. It's up on my shelf. I'll show it to you guys later. If you play Malifaux, fucking Infinity, or even some of the smaller skirmish games, this hard steel framed case is designed for you to throw magnets in the bottom of the bases. It even comes with magnets, and they magnetize to these shelves that you can pull out, as you can see in the bottom of the case. This shit fits in your travel on. You can fly with this shit if you're playing Infinity, Malifaux, fucking anything, War Machine. You can fly with this shit. They're all magnetized in their trays. You don't have to worry about shit. This shit is legend. I put all the clutchest orcs from the Watang clan in this case so that when I fly with my orcs to Adepticon, I'm going to have the best of the orcs with me. And then the rest of the stuff will be in my trap, my check-in. Shit is dope. Foam is clutch. Trust me. Foam is clutch. But this is better than foam, but I promise you, homie. If you, like, this is better. And also, one last chance right here. There's only a couple days left. Macro mats, exclamation point macro mats, I believe, is the trigger here. Did I do that right? No, of course I didn't do it right. God, why can I never remember my commands? What the hell is the command? Can somebody remember? Fucking goddamn it. I think it's been floating around. Whatever. Check it out. Go to Kickstarter. Search macro mats. All one word. This is my man Warboss Doug. He's one of the best individuals on earth. They are producing backdrops for macro photography for miniatures right now. You're not going to want to fucking miss that shit. Thanks, the Great White Buffalo. There's only a couple days left, guys. You're going to want to get on this. All right. Let's go time. So you guys know what step one is. No S at the end. A little bit of flow improvers. Some Vallejo shit right here. We're going to pour some of the Knott's Royal Purple into the pot. That simple. All right. We're going to make sure we're set up here. Always keep the tip clean, guys. And don't forget, guys, if you don't know what the giveaway is, my man Chikuz is winning. Good luck to whoever wins the last Keep It Icy t-shirt. There's no more after this. We have one thing left. We're going to have the hoodie. The hoodie will go up next month. One hoodie. Here we go. It's time to be brave. We're coming on, you know, just kind of normal airbrushing right here. The colors are so close from the paintbrush work we just did that it's all good. Now we're going to get in tight. See that? Just like that, homie. Looked like I was getting a bong ready. Tell your wife I don't know what she's talking about. LT. Okay. So we're going to do a second pass now. Can you see this? This is what we're talking about. Bringing that shit out. Okay, let's let that sit for 1 second. Let's pull out the toothbrush, keep the tip clean. When you're doing shit like this, you want to make sure your flow is right. Swish. I don't know what's going on, brother. I'll figure it out next show and tell. Slanesh Donkey, we're just using this color. It's literally just purple. Vallejo. That's where we're at right now. And we're going over royal purple. Okay, this is where we got to get brave, guys. You got to get in tight. Okay, I'm going to put a little bit more water in the mix. I already know I want it to be a little bit thinner. Okay, very important. Lennox, LOL, or Lot. If you're having problems with airbrush, yo, you gotta check out my YouTube channel. We got literally hundreds of videos on airbrushing all day, every day. So here we go. I'm gonna get in tight on the chest, right on that breast right there. Just like that. I'm gonna throw a little bit of pure air on it. Let it seal up. Flip it around. Let's get that other one. Just like that. Pow. What's up? Let that seal up for a little bit. Someone answer Greenleaf Terrain Studios, please. ! Airbrush. Gotta be brave, guys. Gotta be brave. Let's get the hip. See that? Okay, let's go back to the cloak, the cock robe, and then just build it up again because we're trying to take it to pink. Just that simple, guys. Okay? Now, be patient. This is where, you know, patience is going to fucking come in clutch. Clean that fucking tip. Literally, don't fuck around. Okay, now let's come back in. Let's grab that breast. This is 99% air, guys. 1% paint. You've heard me say it before, and I will not stop saying it to the day I die. Switch over. Same protocol. Let's get that hip. Looking dope. Okay. And we can do a lot. See, we're going to do the same shit back here. All that. Easy mode. But what we're going to do here for this video is we're going to focus on getting this shit just locked in. Okay? So, let's set that down. And now you see, we've got a lot of purple in the pot still. I'm going to pour it all back out into this cup right here. And we got just a little bit left in the pot. And now I'm going to take this magenta, because I want to magenta it up a little bit. And while she's drying, let's not let her just sit on the floor like a homeless person. And also, you know what? Before I exercise bad form on the stream, because I was being lazy, let's clean up our base brush from earlier. I just literally hit it with water, and I don't like doing that. We're just using a little brush soap real quick. I just saw it sitting there, just getting shitty. Okay. Let's get back to it. So we're going to pull some of this magenta out right here. Just like so. This is literally just magenta from Vallejo. Lucky Jawa, what's up, my man? Okay, let's make sure to get a little flow improver in the pot. And let's take that next level. My man, the Great Buffalo, he's going to win this. We're going to grab some squid pink out and pink this up a little bit. There we go. So we've created a brighter color and we've intensified it, made it more vibrant with magenta. Doing the gangster gumbo right here. We're going to prime the pump. Pull back that needle out a couple times. Get that shit ready. We're going to pull our toothbrush out. Okay. We're ready to go. Okay. And this is going to be a little bit more vibrant, but only a little bit brighter. That magenta is really gonna be subtle, but it's gonna be intense. Same time. There it is, grabbing that blouse. Let's get that hip. Flip it around. Let's get the rest of the hip. And as we do it, again, basically paint is transparent. Don't forget. So the more layers you do, the more intense it is. I'm gonna turn the light down just a little bit so maybe you can see it in its glory. That's a little bit more accurate to what we're working here with. We're gonna do one, we're gonna clean the tip real quick. Lax, oh my god, I keep forgetting. Look, guys, Ironheaded, post the video to our most popular video on YouTube, the airbrush hacks video. If you guys are new to my stream and you're curious about some of the things we're doing, some of the lingo we're using, like the gangster gumbo backflow technique, I've got a video that you're going to want to watch on YouTube. My man Ironheaded will post it up. Okay, let's do one last pass on the blouse. Okay, so we're going to take what we have in this pot, okay, and we're going to save it, because this is good. This is a good color. Okay, we're going to pour it out into this ancient Chinese technique water bottle lid. We're going to pour a little water in this pot, dump it in the hobo sink. Now we're going to brighten this up a little bit, guys. So we're going to reach back into our squid pink mix right here. And we're going to pink it up. A little flow improver. Boom. There it is. I'll do what I can. I do what I can, my man. Wouter Van Asadonk. Thank you, brother. Of course, I have a Patreon page. I don't like to promote it too much, but it exists. If you're looking for the studio tutorials that I do and you want to see them before anybody else with no ads, you know, Patreon, homies. But you don't have to, because everything I do goes to YouTube delayed with ads. But you can see it for free. Okay. Okay, this is going to be brighter, guys. You ready? There we go. You see that? See what's happening here? It's very thin down. When you go into that bright color, you gotta go thin, man. It's gotta be like water. Okay. Now, like I said, you can't be impatient. You gotta clean the tip when you're going bright. Let's swing back up into the chest right here. Let's get that breast right there. That's 99% air, guys. Barely any paint left the tip there. Just like that. I'm gonna clean the tip again. I'm even going to add just a little bit more water to the pot. Just a drop. All right. Let's get this other side right here. Get the hip. Okay. As I've said dozens of times, paint is transparent. So it, as it dries, it's going to mute down. So I'm going to blow a little bit of air on it to help it dry faster. Simple, simple. And then we're going to add another light coat just so it can look its brightest. That simple. Let's go right back up to the chest. Very light, all air. Okay, we're gonna let her, we're gonna let this mat down, because that's the thing. The longer you let the paint dry, you know, like, the more it's going to mat down. We're going to save this mix. We're going to leave it in the pot. I normally don't recommend this, but I'm a professional. And we'll turn the compressor off just for a minute. And we're going to do a quick show and tell session while Ilario mats down a little bit, because we're going to take this pink to the next level. We're going to pop it out. But before then, let's do a quick show and tell. What's going on here? So people are talking about things. Big shout out to my man Ironheaded, world's greatest mod, for keeping the channel civil and doing what he does. Kangaroo Court, Lucky Jawa, yeah. That shit was ridiculous. All right. Okay, let's do it, guys. Exclamation point show. I want to see what you guys are working on. We're going to start off where we left off. Oh my God, we got so many pictures in here. Here we go. So let's start off with Sons of Horus, Legion Champion, my man Leonid Lopez. See what he's working on. Oh, I love that conversion, my man. That shit is looking so fresh. Way to incorporate him into like that 40K world. That's dope. Way to hold it down, brother. Leonid Lopez in the hizzy. Looking good, brother. Big shout out. Okay, let me approve a couple more real quick. Casual Gaming Time, Great White Buffalo, Dungeon Master Brad. Let's see what's going on here. Okay, haven't decided yet what color to paint this. Obviously green or pink, green or purple, purple or green. I can't really think of any other colors, my man. It's very cool looking though. Good job, homie. Okay, let's take a look at Sicarian Battle Tank by AV6 Scott. I think he has a painting studio, or maybe not. Yo, good job. The Sicarian is so clutch. Excuse me, guys. Yo, it's okay, man. Sometimes I get repeated. I'll handle it. In the meantime, I need a little bit more iced tea to get the day going. Is this the one? Good job, brother. Let's take a look at the Great White Buffalo doing that orc chanter, the shaman. Yo, yellow. Good job, brother. Got that Age of Sigmar love. Dragon dropping bits off. Pow! T. Black Carapace is a tech for Marines. Nice. That's my man Ironheaded right there. All day, every day. If you guys don't know what we're doing a little community show and tell on the integrated show and tell page at slowfusegaming.com on the Whip Gallery. Exclamation point show, jumping on this. Here's my man, Dungeon Master Brad. Doing a Dwarven Paladin. Pow! This man, you don't even understand the level that his D&D group is at. Over 9,000. Gabriel Tosh Specter. I don't know what you're talking about. I do know what you're talking about. Isn't that like a major difference between like Astartes and other people who wear power armor? This paladin looks fresh, my man. Don't give up your love, your passion. Forge NZ painting my kindred spirit. Great White Buffalo. I'm gonna bury the one because you already posted it. War Child. Somebody posted a picture without a name. Borax. It's actually, turns out it's Swish. I'm gonna approve that one. People are approving left away. I'll do a big shout out here in a second for all the redemptions. For Gen Z, this is my kindred spirit. The Mauler Fiend is life. If I were a model in 40K, I would be a Mauler Fiend, I'm convinced. Good job with that purple, brother. Dathar, thanks for the sub, my man. That man is a legend. Keeps it icy all day, every day. Good job, my man. Let's take a look at my man, Sidrian, with Samael, Master of the Ravenwing, on his jet bike, looking like a beast. Keyline Prime, you talking about Mauler Fiends? Mauler Fiends, they can be MPVs as long as you don't play in tournaments with grab guns. You know what makes a Mauler Fiend sad as fuck? Someone rolling a 6 on a grab gun, it's worse than getting blown up. Mauler Fiend obesity. That's true. But Mauler Fiends, I mean, I get a lot of play with them. I use Shroud, come in behind runes, get 2 up cover, bypass. I do a lot of things, especially with the new, if you guys don't know about the Heretech psychic power chart in the new psychic powers, it's one of my favorite charts to roll on when I go up against the Gladius Strike Force with all their grabs, because they have Dark Invigoration, which literally is a level 1 warp charge. If you have a Dark Cabal or even just 2 psychers like I always do, literally it heals an immobilization result. It's a level 1 warp charge. It's like a 24 inch range, and it'll bring back a whole point if you're not healing immobilization. You know what's dope? Coming up with all these Mauler Fiends and then having them immobilize both of them. And then they get out of position and you go heal. And he still charges you. Yo, that's just clutch. Yeah, Wood of Van Acidonk. You heard me, dog. Like, that's what I'm saying. Okay, let's take a look at my man Warchild, working on some Dark Angels, Contemptor pattern dreadnoughts. He's got the green, the black, and the white. Yo, this is like Power Rangers right here. Take a look at this, guys. I'm going to be playing, I'm going to be going to LVO, guys. I'm also going to be going to Adepticon. If you guys want to meet me at either event, definitely that's going to be a premier stop right there. I'm going to be playing some Chaos Demons. I'm not going to be playing the Orcs anytime soon. Just, I got too many obligations, so I'm going to be going old school with Demons. I'll be borrowing some models from my man, Rob. We get a lot of models in the Beats Lab, and I'm going to be borrowing another Pro Painter's models, and I'm going to be repping them at LVO. If you want to hear more about it, find me at LVO. But I'll be playing my Rot Swarm Nurgle. It's a pretty solid army that not a lot of people know about. I play a Rot Swarm formation with a Demon Cad, and I got some other tricks up these sleeves. call me the Magic Man. What the red, fuck? So Saldok has decided that that shirt is his. The last, keep it, always keep the tip clean shirt. Let me show you. If you guys don't know why this shirt is epic, let me just throw it up on the screen real quick. Obviously, this man deserves some shout outs, some love, some hype. Saldok, you're a beast. And I expect to see a selfie of you because Saldok and I are about the same size. Saldok, right? 6 feet tall, about 280. I weigh about 287, 6 feet. The 3XL is a little big on me, but if I cut the sleeves off, it's perfect. So if you guys don't know what we're talking about, let me throw it up on the screen. Of course, the biggest. My man, Kellex. What's up, brother? Kellex also deserves some heat. Yo, keep up an awesome stream. I'm always fishing for new painting stuff to try. Yo, big shout out, my man. Appreciate it. So this is it, guys. We did a big run of these shirts in October. We sold 60 of them. 60 of you guys are floating around with these shirts. We only have one left, 3XL. The winner of the top donator giveaway today goes home with the last shirt. And I will use a metallic gold fabric marker, which I have. Oz Pete got one last week. I will autograph this motherfucker. If you value my autograph, I'm not saying you do. I don't fucking value that motherfucker. But if you do, I will slap it on there for you, homie. That is what the top donator giveaway is. That's what the hype is. It's the last of its kind. Next month, we'll be giving away the only hoodie in existence. So even though he's going to get this shirt autographed, and maybe 60 other people have this shirt without the autograph, next month, the only hoodie on earth will be going out. Saldok, thank you, my brother. I'm pretty sure this shirt is yours, homie. Back to the show and tell. Okay, my man Swish right here. Let's take a look at these Sisters of Silence. Is this it? Why is the picture so small? God damn it. It's the best I can do, guys. I'm sorry it's blurry. But Swish, get a bigger picture. Get a bigger camera. I don't know which bigger megapixels. The Sisters of Silence. It does look glorious though, my man. Son of Bjorn. I'm thinking about going to Nova this year in 2007. 2017 is going to be a big year for the Long War Network, Next Level Painting, Slow Fuse Gaming, Spiky Biz TV. Shit's going to get real. We're going to be doing some stuff. I'm not going to take Nova off the table. I might be at ATC's as well. ATC might be the first time I bring the orcs out, guys. That's straight up. Swiss, great job on the sisters. You're killing it, my man. Let's take a look at my man Borax. Let's take a look at the Mortis engine. What the fuck is this? That is tight, homie. Son of Bjorn, I've been to Nova dozens of times. I mean, not dozens of times. I've been there like three times. I played in the Invitational a couple times. Last time I went, we actually let everyone on the pick my army list. And it was the old Blood Angels Codex in 7th edition. And I let everyone pick it, and they said they wanted me to play Blood Angels. I went like 6 and 8 with Blood Angels at Nova. The only person I lost to two people. One of the people I lost to was my man. I can't remember his name. Justin Cox, is his name? No, Jay Cox, different person. Justin Cook. Justin Cook, he won that year with a Tau list. He beat me. Son of Bjorn, I hope to see you there. Good job on this Mortis engine, my man. Finishing up my old Aramon before the new one drops. War Angel. Let's take a look, my man. Speaking of Aramon, first off, clutch work, homie. Second off, we've got multiple Prosperal Burn swag crates with the new Aramon in them right now. Yo, it's all random. You don't know what you're going to get, but it's up in the Revlo store, I'm sure. Musefi. You'll be at LVO. You'll be in the Warhammer 40K for Dummies. Musefi says, "Look, just look for all the paints, all the fainting females. Easiest way to find me. Fainting females." Musefi, are you a lady? Are you one of the rare ladies that frequents the hobby? Because we got all the ladies in Next Level Painting. It does look like a Geiger artwork, doesn't it, Ebb and Flow? Real quick, guys. This is the last stream of the beard for No Shave November. We'll be back to keeping it icy with fresh sideburns. But real quick, I might do a vote. I asked my lady about this. Now, imagine if I just shaved the chin. Let me go to this real quick. If I just shave this, and I just have that, like it's an 1800s like sheriff or mayor of an old town, like old timey West. Could that be the new look? I don't know. My lady says it should not be the new look at all costs. I'll let you guys weigh in on that. All right, good job on this, Aramon, my man. Wait, I am? If you're a lady, shout out to the ladies. Real shadows, lady? What? Beard is better? Come on, man, ain't no beards. Beard is better than the iciest sideburns in the business? The Civil War beard. That's exactly what I'm thinking. It's like the Civil War beard. Dragon. I feel you. My lady ain't into it. She doesn't even like this. Oh. Somebody just redeemed for double X Yo Dogs. Memnoir. Big shout out to Memoir. Yeah, Lemmy. All right, rip. Y'all was just at the Rainbow the other day with my lady. They got the bronze of Lemmy there. He used to play video poker there literally every weekend. My lady used to write there. She was friends with him. So we came out there to pay our respects just a couple weeks ago. Rip. Oh, Musefi, you're a man. Well, that's fine. I got no problem with men. All right, guys. We're almost ready to get back to it. Let's do just a couple more. R. Dilgart. God damn it. Testing mate. Okay, you guys got to put your names on these. Literally. Guys are crazy. Okay, this is the last round. We're going to get back to the airbrushing. Okay, let's take a look at my man R. Dilgart working on the Orux. Yeah, I was looking fresh, brother. Wood of Van Asseldunk? That's baller, dude. That's true, Ebb and Flow. It's a fact. That's a fucking fact. Scientific fact. Still one more name. So back in the day, here's a fun story. If you guys want, okay, I'll let you guys. It's kind of a medium length story, maybe 5 minutes. I have a fun anecdote about the old timey West beard. If you want to hear it, I'll tell it. If you don't want to, just say no. No big deal. I don't have to tell it if it's not interesting. Let me know, guys. Oh, this is the Blood Bowl heat. Oh, shit. This is going to be so tight. Burnsides, the Great White Buffalo. Yo, all day, brother. Blood Bowl. You know we're going to be paying some Blood Bowl on the stream. Okay, I don't know who. Someone claimed this towel model. I don't know who painted it, but it looks really fucking good, guys. Charles Clausing. Good work, brother. This is fucking legit, homie. Got a couple votes for story time. Look, if you're worried about hurting my feelings, you're abstaining from the voting process. You will not hurt my feelings by telling me you don't want to hear a fucking story. It's about the old timey West beard. I have had it once before for exactly one day. It's a hilarious story. I think it is, at least. But you can say no. A couple people say they want to hear it. Captain Artemis by Ty Winning. Little known fact about Ty Winning, he is actually the most squanchy viewer. Hold my tea. Absinthe knows. All right, we'll do a quick story. So for years I pour concrete. I may have mentioned this back in the old days. So like I'll set the pace with this. So anytime like I think what I do is monotonous or tiring, like, oh, I'm just painting models all day every day, I always think back to the 7 years that I poured concrete to pay rent and eat ramen. And I remember, like, this shit is easy. Get the fuck over it, you know? So back in the old days, to pour concrete, I used to do a lot of work around Philong Ford in Colorado. I did a lot of maintenance for the dealerships. I did a lot of concrete, big contracts. And for a couple years, I was there. And so basically, the mechanics that, because I did a lot of work in the big, huge mechanic bay and the big shop, they were all dicks. They basically were like, they were like my boss, is what they thought. You know, like, fix this, fix that, fix this. You know, I'm like, I'm just here to fix concrete, guys. Like, I'm not fucking some rando, you know, but that's what they thought about me. So they treated me like a dick all the time, right? So one day, you know, we're doing our thing. I grew my beard out for Halloween or some shit. And then my buddy Dom, he was my roommate. Big shout out, DJ LNT. He used to come to all the conventions with us, spin that wax. He was like, yo, you should shave it up. Old timey West. I'm talking couple of years of all the mechanics, especially this one guy toward the front of the bay, always was a dick to me, right? Always was a dick. So I shave in the old timey West, you know, we're talking, I look like the, you know, 1800s mayor, like literally walking around the dealership with my new beard, my tool bags, everything, doing some maintenance. And this guy, standard dick move, comes up to me like, hey, I need you to fucking get on this, like shit, 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 blah, blah, blah. And he's not even looking at me because this motherfucker doesn't even look at me anymore. You know what I'm saying? And like, he's just down there doing some mechanic bullshit. And I'm just walking by like, yo, man, I literally don't have time. You ask me this kind of shit every day, man. I got other things to do. And he stands up, spins around like he's getting ready to like fucking post up on me. Like, look, you little fucking fuck, you know, maintenance motherfucker. And he turns around and sees the beard. He sees the new old-timey West mustache or whatever it's called. Instantaneously takes a step back. Just instantaneously, he's like, oh yeah, I mean, if you have time, sir. Like, I mean, this guy's been shitting on me for 2 years, doesn't even know my name. Turns around, takes a step back, he's like, oh yeah, you know, like, totally fucking different, like, instantaneous respect. Old timey West takes a step back, says, yeah man, when you got time, you know, like, obviously, brother. Didn't mean to get in your, you know, didn't mean now. Like, obviously, I didn't mean now. You're obviously busy. You know what I mean? He was totally backpedaling. And then I walked out of it. I was like, the old-timey West commands respect in a certain, you know, set of circumstances. Because then later that night, I went to the club with my boys down in the Springs, and no lady would talk to me. I was like, hey, what's up, girl? She's like, get out of here with that beard. So it is a give and take, you know, so... That happened. That's 100% fact. Promise you guys. Reiner. Thanks, my man. Blow up the bits. Okay, good story. Glad you guys didn't think it was too dumb. Let's get back to painting, guys. Big shout out to everyone with the Whip Gallery. I'll get back to you guys. You don't get a lot of play with the beard, homie. Like, You know, like my lady met me with the sideburns. She always liked the sideburns. I started shaving the sideburns out and just running like a 5 o'clock shadow. And she was like, you need to get the sideburns back. I was like, so ladies like sideburns, but they don't like old timey West beards? The fuck? Okay, guys. It's time to get Swifty. Swifty! Let's turn the compressor on. Deathart, I'm sorry you missed the story. Psyduck, you can't grow a beard? I thought you were like 6 feet tall, 300 pounds. I thought everybody who had that size could grow a beard. I thought it was my body's obesity, natural obesity, like expelling fat from my body. Okay, so we poured some of the pink out because now we're going to throw a little white in the pot. But we, as I always talk about, you always want to keep the common link from the previous color. It's true. Devil Man, I know. That's she'll let me do it because she loves me. But she's like, just recognize I'm going to fucking hate it. Like... Okay, we poured a little white in there. Psyduck, that's interesting. You're like Rob Bear. That's how Robbie B is. I'll tell you what, I have the opposite problem, homie. Okay. Viking teabagger. That's ridiculous. Sorry, not sorry. We're doing it. Mayor Beard. It's happening. We'll do one stream with the Mayor Beard. And then I have to let it grow back because I'm going to visit my parents for Christmas. And I can't sully their experience, which is picture taking, with that beard. Okay, keep the tip clean, guys. It's about to get icy in here. Devil May Fizz. Are you guys from a different country? Because this is not what happens here. Okay, so the trick when you're going so bright, guys, is you got to thin that paint down. Priming the pump off screen just a little bit. I'm going to keep that tip clean. Okay, now so there's a lot of white here, guys, and you want to be subtle. Okay, it's very thin, still not thin enough. So we're going to pour a little flow improver back in the pot, just a little bit more water. Scotty No Nose, true story, right? Iron Headed. Something tells me Iron Headed is the master of photobombing his own family photos. All right, there we go. 99% air, guys. You guys know the trick. If you lose video, do a refresh. It's the best we can do, brother. We have dropped literally no frames during this show, and we're actually holding strong. Good news, I did put in an order for an upgrade on the internet connection because now I can afford a little bit more thanks to your guys' generosity. So I've doubled my bill, but also doubled my upload speeds. The modem is actually sitting in the living room. I'm going to fucking upgrade everything after this show, so we might be able to bring a little bit more quality starting next month. Real Shadow. And Real Shadow said that Real Shadow was a lady. Confirm that you're a lady, Real Shadow, and that you like facial hair. Okay, we're gonna bring this wide up to the chest, guys. This is the moment of truth. This is bravery. You're gonna wanna be on your shit right now. All air, just a little bit of paint. Like that. Now, I'm gonna immediately clean the tip. Just a little bit more water. Let's get the other side. Just like that. Okay, let's get the rib cage. All air. So little paint. Reiner 72, yeah, Model Masters doesn't fucking play games, homie. Borax, keep it icy, brother. Yo, show that man some love. Borax, the $5 donation, always keeping it icy, getting those Yo Dogs. Spend them in the Revelo store, guys. Okay, let's jump on this hip. Switch around. All about that air. Pow. And the reason that we're focusing on this part is because all this is actually really easy for me to do not on stream. Like, I can bang that out so quick. I'm doing the tricky shit right now for you guys. Oh, snizznap. I imagine Absinthe is trying to get something. Absinthe with a very specific donation. I imagine she's really close to redeeming something. Big shout out to our redeemers today. John Bingham with the Death Watch gift bundle. Killex with the Death Watch. Chinkuza with the Death Watch. Orc Pride with the Death Watch. LT with Prospero. And of course, our main man, Demonicon. He'd redeemed a couple of weeks ago, but he did get the epic swag crate of the Cult Gene Stealer models, valued at almost $300. Big shout out, guys. And also, we have triggered the Mystery Bits giveaway. Top tier is the Great White Buffalo. Congrats, my man. Whoever wins the top tiered giveaway today gets a special gift bag. Totally random, and I won't even tell you what's in it. Just got to wait and see. Devil Man, yes, I watched it. I don't want to talk about it. Okay, let's do a second pass. Like I said, the paint always dries a little bit transparent. It looks way more vibrant when it's wet, and then it gets a little bit more dulled out. Oh, there's a redemption. Let me just double check and see if I was right. Yep. What's up? You go, girl. Absinthe. Getting that Death Watch. Just a little bit more, and then we're gonna call it good right there. There it is. Okay, so now we gotta go 1 degree higher. Gotta take it to pure white. So I'm gonna rinse out the airbrush in the hobo sink. Lock Infinity, Kenny. Oh my god. If I attach a Terminator HQ with Relentless to a squad of guardsmen, do they have Relentless? No. Relentless does not confer. The rule you're looking for is slow and purposeful. Slow and purposeful confers, but not very many solo people have it. A really cool trick is if you want to get ridiculous is you can do 2 chapter masters on foot with no upgrades. And they can join a unit of Centaurians, and Centaurians are slow and purposeful, hence they're slow and purposeful, so they can move around, and they can drop 2 orbital strikes. And if you want, you can use Splitfire, because you can buy the Omniscope, so you can actually, on turn 1, shoot all the grav guns here, and then Omniscope the infinite range of 1 orbital strike here on turn 1, then do it again on turn 2. You may have miscalculated, Absinthe. Okay, we just cleaned out the airbrush. We're going to throw a little pure white in there. Ironheaded, yeah. So, cataphract the armor gives you slow and purposeful, so that's how you do it. Assassin Red, bubbles. If you get bubbles in your paint from just pressing the button, that's bad. It means it's clogged. If you get bubbles in your paint because you clogged it on purpose, that doesn't mean anything. We're gonna pour a little white up in here. Who said that was broken? That sounds broken as hell, Scotty No-Nos. If you think that's broken, then I love your local meta. What is this? Slow Fuse Gaming donating money? What is he doing? I think I know what he's doing. I know exactly what he's doing here. I have a feeling that he just donated $20 to get $20 in Yodog so that he can redeem a special prize on our stream. But I also think that he's my best friend. Big shout out to Slow Fuse Gaming. And Howdy, if Howdy's on here, Howdy, I gave you your 500 Yodogs that you won on Slow Fuse's stream earlier today. Okay, we're going pure white. So white has to be watered down. I like that. Okay. If I know Slow Fuse, he's going to redeem. Yep. He just picked up a Death Watch gift bag. And I imagine if I know him, that's not the end of it. Slow Fuse, I think Slow Fuse has an announcement to make. So I think what Slow Fuse Gaming is saying is that he just redeemed a Death Watch gift bag and he wants me to raffle it off to one of you guys. That's what Slow Fuse Gaming brings to the table. Okay, real quick. We got that white. I'm going to add that white into the very tip. And then we're going to do this raffle, guys. See this? Just like that. We're going to blow some pure air on it. Okay. Let me let this sit. Let me clean the airbrush out. Let's give away a gift bag, guys. Let me dump out the pot into the hobo sink. Run a little bit of clear water through it. Let's turn the compressor off. Okay. Real quick. This is what we got. This is what we accomplished with your guys' guidance. And we just gotta come in and do some clutch brush work to the top of the blouse. Okay, so my man Slow Fuse Gaming the dark skin is going to be clutch because we're going to make everything so bright that that it's going to just be perfect. Okay, guys. Let's get ready for a giveaway, guys. Alright guys, here's what's about to happen. No, I'll send it. Nope. For raffles, I send them anywhere, man. I can't do that to you guys. This is a worldwide raffle. Anyone in the fucking world is gonna be able to get this. Pay attention to the stream right now. The keyword is gonna be Slow Fuse, all one word. I'll put the timer up in just a minute. There we go. Keyword, slow fuse. 2 minute timer has begun. Everybody, this is everyone's available to get this. Good luck. Exclamation point, slow fuse. This is courtesy of my main man, Jason Craze, aka Slow Fuse Gaming. Free swag, guys. Jump in on this. There's like 200 people in here, man. I expect to see every bit of 150 entries. Come on, guys. Exclamation point, slow fuse. You're going to win a Death Watch mini character from the Cassius set with resin to accompany it. Free shipping to your doorstep. Whisper me after the stream. We'll get you hooked up. About to get real. I can't believe we don't have already 100 people in there. You guys are cray. Big booty sorceress. Real shadow. People are earning 2x Yodogs for the next 2 minutes, courtesy of Borax. Hype that man up. Great White Buffalo dropping bombs. Devilman, Tobacco, Route 66. That's what I do. All right, guys. I just knocked the router over. Hopefully that's fine. Good Lord. Okay, we got 89 entries. Now, first, I want to say congratulations to the winner before we draw this. And I also want to say thanks for playing, guys. And big shout out to my man Slow Fuse Gaming. A little bit more iced tea. Let's draw a winner, guys. Liam Edes. What's up, brother? Okay. You guys ready to draw a winner? Saldok, are you kidding me? Saldok is large and in charge. Holy shit. That man is winning free Death Watch swag courtesy of Slow Fuse Gaming, the sponsor of that give bag. And he is also the top donator to win this t-shirt. Yo, mad love. Mad love. Where you at, Saldok? Where you at? The motherfucker taking a shit? There he is. There it is. Congratulations, my brother. Congrats. Big shout out. Much love. We are a stream team, guys. This is Brushlickers United. This is also the Long War Network, The Long War on Twitch. And if you guys don't know, check us out on Facebook. This just happened today, The Long War Network. Shit's going to be getting real. Spike Abyss TV is coming to Twitch. We're going to be starting to stream Monday news shows, hobbies every day. We're going to get crazy here. Definitely going to want to jump in on that Facebook group. I want to see what you guys are doing. I want to see your podcasts. I want to see your YouTube channels. I want to see your Twitch streams. Let me do a quick promotion real quick. Ace Case, exclamation point Ace Case. Help me out here, guys. Ace Case. These guys literally sent me one of these boxes. It's glorious. I magnetized all the orcs. Shit is so clutch. I'll show you guys here real quick in 1 second. Shit is out of control. All right, guys. I'm going to show you guys right here. Exclamation point. A case. You see, it's a very, it's carry on. You literally carry this bitch on a plane. And you can definitely put an entire small skirmish army in here. The trays completely slide out. And they're I magnetize the orcs to it. Take a look at this. Look at that shit. If you were gonna fly, with your army to a convention and you had some nice metal fucking Malifaux models or some fucking And here's what's dope. This is what I figured out about it right here. So the bottom one, you can put it, you can make it bigger or smaller by putting it on a tray or not. And look at all this. Look at this. So you can travel to your conventions in style. This is all metal, dog. Like, this is a solid metal frame. Like, you can drop this. Should be fine. If I was going to fly with this, I would throw packing peanuts inside of here. Zip this motherfucker up. Carry this bitch on. Got my whole fucking army right there. Big shout out. Obviously, AK is doing what they do. And let's do one last shout out for my man, Macro Matt. Exclamation point, Macro Matt. War Boss Doug, good friend of the show. Yo, you're not going to want to check out these photography backdrops. There's only a couple more days left in the Kickstarter. You're going to want to get on these backdrops. These are so tight. All day, every day. Definitely check these out. Glorious. Okay, guys, let's do a quick show and tell. I want to see what you guys are working on. We cut the last one kind of short with story time. I'm going to jump right in here with my man Howdy. Looking like he's doing some Ultramarines. Right here. Good job, brother. Keeping it icy. Yeah, exclamation point A case will take you to the armycase.com shop. Real Shadow, do you have those purple drop pods with you? No, those are a commission from years ago. Yo, I've been flying with armies for years. They always take a look at it. They never open it. They always kind of look at me like it's funny, and then I tell them what it is, and they're all good with it. Great job, brother. Howdy. Let's see what my man AV6 Scott with his Dark Angels Contemptor Drenna. Oh my god. This is glorious. Dathar and a hizzy. Contempt, our Dreadnought does not play games. Warchild. I think we already saw this earlier. The green, the black, the white. Good job, Warchild. Gene Stealer Cult. Patriarch by my main man, Yori Kasudan, fellow streamer. Take a look at this. Shit is baller. Iron-headed, yeah. It's like 270 points. And he stands still. He's got Skyfire Intercept. But yeah, you can play that shit. Then he gets charged by five Tactical Marines and doesn't get to shoot for four turns. This looks great, Yori. Hashtag make Dreadnoughts great again. Let's bury that. War Child got crazy. Kaiser Wolf. Somebody with no name. Okay, let's take a look at these. Player J checking in. Let's see what he's working on. Zach decided he didn't like green, so we changed it. Well, that's boring. He didn't like green, but that looks great, dog. Good job, my man. Yo, Jesse, you're getting ill with the airbrush, homie. War Child, here's the thing. You're not going to see the upload until I approve it. So, I promise it uploads. Yeah, still one more name. Straight up. Dreadnoughts should be monstrous creatures and they should have a toughness value. GW, hire me as a consultant. I literally would do it for free. Like, I'm not even... Like, I would sign an NDA. Send me your second to final draft. I'll circle XXX. This is why this is stupid. This is why this is good. Shit like that, bro. Literally, I would do it for free. Retain my consultation fee, please. Of $0. Player J, you're getting so good. One of the best. Kaiser Wolf. Trying to decide what to do with the Thunderhammer. Let's see. Excuse me, guys. I'm thinking non-metal stony blue. Make it like it's rock, like a sick rock, but make it a little bit on the blue side of the spectrum. I think that should be sick. Mont DJ, legend. Dragon, you should give them a petition. If you guys can get a petition going and post it on their community page, on their Facebook page, Kenny Boucher, Next Level Painting, consultation fee for future, free consultant for future rules, has the hobby, is equal parts hobby, equal parts competitive play, literally, I'll take that job for free. I spend literally 80 hours a week on Warhammer 40K because I love it. Viking Teabagger, yeah, we've got two battle reports on YouTube where we play Dreadnoughts with toughness as monstrous creatures. Let's take a look at this. This is a rock solid Lizard Man, no name attached to it. Somebody please claim this model. Saldok, it shocked me, bro. It shocked me. The new Traitor's Legions, I literally am speechless. Can't wait to see what comes out of it, brother. This Lizard Man's out of control, though. Lanix Lots. Oh, Clanix. He said Clanix. So it's... Got it. Clanix. This looks fucking legendary, brother. Great job, homie. What we're saying, Real Shadow, is that tanks suck balls. They're awful. Like, a Dreadnought's garbage. Like, a Dreadnought should just have a toughness value. Like, it should just be a monstrous creature. Literally, we've talked about it many times. If a Dreadnought is if a Terminator has a 2-up, 5-up, and he's tactical Dreadnought armor, in my opinion, an easy way to make a Dreadnought work is give him a 2-up, 5-up, toughness 6, 4 wounds. That's it. He would literally be 10 times more playable. And he's now he's a monstrous creature, so he's at AP 2. In close combat. That simple. You know? Grav guns would be less effective against them. People are like, oh, you get killed by grav. I was like, do you play 40K right now? Because 1-6 means he can't ever move again. And now they would have to roll twos, but you get saves all over the place. I honestly think they should be three up armor save, toughness seven, feel no pain. That's with four wounds. Literally game changer. Let's move on. Let's take a look at my main man, Fabules Karn. Looking beast. What did he say here? He said Karn from my local GW store manager who is a true pimp. So somebody else painted this? Because that is a pimp. That's a pimp job. Emotes only mode. 2 minutes engaged by interrupt speed. You can only use emotes for 2 minutes, guys. It's awesome. Good job, homie. Whoever paid this. Casual gaming time. New bases for the 1K Suns. Did you stamp these out yourself? Holy shit, dude. Look at these bases for the 1K Suns. Emo only mode is so gangster. It's so gangster. I love seeing you guys paint your words with emotes. His bases are so tight, homie. All right. Hydra Ascendant, Black Templar, Death Watch Captain. My word, this is a legendary paint job, brother. Emo only. So beast. You guys can talk again. Yeah, this shit's mad dope, though, man. Like, fuck yeah, homie. Jack Trauma, yeah. Okay, look, if you spam anything, you can beat somebody in the right circumstance. So if you spam Armor 13 Dreadnoughts with frag cannons inside of Lucius Pattern drop pods where they get Shroud, so they have 3-up cover save when they use their smoke launchers, and you spam 5 of those, you can beat some people. Yeah, no doubt. No doubt. You know what I mean? But what I'm talking about is somebody should be able to just take a Dreadnought and feel like it might do something one day. Because right now, if you take a Dreadnought in your Space Marine army, what a waste. Like, what the fuck are you going to do with that Dreadnought? He's just going to walk around and not do anything the whole game. You know? That's what I mean. I'm not talking about things that you spam being good. If you spam anything, it's good. You know what I mean? It's better, at least. That's the big problem right now. Dreadnoughts are not even playable. Like, look at a Dread Knight. 130-point Dread Knight has 4 wounds, 2 up, 5 up, is a monstrous creature, T6, has weapon skill 5, force weapon, a psyker, hammer hand, literally for 5 points, is, you know, strength 10, force hammer. Like, it's already strength 10. Like, literally 130, and it can deep strike. Like, it's the best Dreadnought in the game. You know? Always Tang. Let's take a look at the Blood Angels. Come at me, brah. That is a dope looking paint job, homie. Ironheaded. How long do Dreadnoughts last versus Grav? About as long, I mean, longer than Dreadnoughts. They're monstrous creatures, dog. They can just toe touch 4-up cover. Like, I'm in a ruin. I have 4+ cover. They have to literally do 8 grav results to kill a Dreadnought. You have to roll 1-6 and the Dreadnought will never walk again. That's the same thing as being destroyed. Same thing. So let me put it this way. When 10 grav cannon shots from a Gladius' Devastator Squad and a Rhino shoot a Dreadnought, 100% chance it doesn't ever walk again.
And his name is John C.
Jaeger, Jaegera or Jaegera? 51, 57, big shout out, $7 getting those Yo-Dogs. That's a very specific number, my man. Big hype, brother. But when 10 grav cannon shots shoot a Dreadnought, it's not guaranteed to destroy it. Because if it only does 7 wounds and it's toe dragging some terrain, it might survive. You know what I'm saying? So that's what's up. But also, you know, it's just, I got a lot of opinions on this. I've been talking about it for years.
Moonman.
Impulse.
Goodbye.
Yo, diggity dogs.
Moonman.
Shut the f*** up about Moonmen.
Big shout out. Big shout out, Impulse. Getting those Yo-Dogs. Love you, homie. Hype him up. My main man, Forge NC, says, don't forget about Sanctuary. Dreadnoughts don't have Sanctuary. They used to. But now they don't. I don't think they do, at least. Do they? If they do, then fuck yeah. I thought they just had Hammerhand. Is it Hammerhand? I thought they had Hammerhand and... Hammerhand and the one that makes demons have difficult terrain around them? Banish? Or something like that? Banishment? Wicked Wombat. Toe dragging in terrain... Ruins say that as long as any part of the model touches terrain, it benefits from the cover. So ruins give you a 4-up cover as long as you're touching the terrain, unless you're a vehicle, in which vehicles need to be 25% obscured. Moss's creatures can toe drag a ruin, just like an infantry model, and get 4-up cover. So you can toe drag, literally just touch a ruin as you're, you know, with a Dreadnought, and it's got 4-up cover. Dreadnoughts come preloaded with psychic powers. As a matter of fact, I got a motherfucking Grey Knight Codex right here, homies. I'm gonna flip this bitch. I got the special edition. Magnetized. I'm gonna flip over to Dreadnoughts right here. Dreadnoughts, Psychics. Oh, they know Banishment and Sanctuary. Okay, yeah. So a Dreadnought can be 4-up and vulnerable. All on its own, guys, which means it doesn't need to cover. I think it was for gargantuan creatures. I'm not sure. I haven't memorized the new GW FAQ yet. Yeah, toe dragging's a little bit ridiculous, but heard that. The Pervy Monk, Hood's Gate LT. I think most events are pretty common sense. Tomcat, I am not the best guy to ask for that. You might want to ask Slow Fuse Gaming. Hit up at Slow Fuse. I'm sure he's in the chat. Whisper his ass. He knows what's up. That's more his style. God damn it. I went back too many times. Pervy Monk. Looking good, brother. Still one more name. He knows. He'll be my fact checker. I'm digging that. Got that Sylvaneth. Pervy Monk in the hizzy. Hood's Gate. Let's take a look at this Vanguard. Oh my goodness. Hood's Gate in a hizzy. I haven't memorized the new GW shit yet. We'll talk about it a little bit on Wednesday in the podcast. We did an article on Spiky Bits about it, but the thing is I'm going to LVO in a couple weeks, and LVO it is probably going to use some of it, but anything they voted on, they're not going to change. So I've been committing ITC FAQ to memory. Bring my demons there. Yo, this Vanguard looks dope. Okay, guys. Apologize if I didn't get to your show and tell this evening. Good news. Tomorrow's Whip Wednesday on Slow Fuse Gaming, which means the upvotes are going to get prizes. So go in there, vote for your favorite pieces. Check out Slow Fuse tomorrow. Get your free swag. And I'm going to do a little bit more work on this model. Okay, we're going to get locked in the cradle, guys, and I'm going to do a little bit of edging on this girl and show you what I got. Okay, let's kick it up a notch. Pull out an ancient Chinese technique, water bottle lid. We're gonna pour a little bit of this pink. So just a little bit of the water residue. Get a little white in there. AV6 Scott, that's what's up. That's a good change. Well, that's a good FAQ. Which is why I want Dreadnoughts to have Feel No Pain. I want them to have a 3-up, 5-up, Feel No Pain. Okay, this is what we're going to do, guys. We're going to take some of this white. And we're going to do a quick little edge. Take it all the way to the top. Just like that. Get that nice edge in there. You want to get in tight for this. Not easy. Boom. Yo, exclamation point paintbrush, bro. That's what we use. We only use cheap brushes here. Okay, same deal right here. And I love to get that bright edge highlight in the dark areas too. It's how you create that electricity. Super contrast. That's what we do here. Like so. Okay, same deal. You can do the same thing with the leaves. Just doing some nice clean white edges. Excuse me, guys. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a little bit of our original purple, mix it in with the white, subdue it just a little bit, and we're going to just manufacture a couple folds right here. Like so. Very thin down paint. My hands are not the steadiest right now. We've had a lot of iced tea. We can take a little bit of that magenta. Keep it thin. Then we're going to add a little bit of white back into it. Get a nice little highlight there in the cut. The great white buffalo. Am I taking commissions right now? Yeah, but it's like a year wait. And I am pretty close to not taking commissions for a little while. Got a lot of work to catch up on commission-wise. So I'd say, like, honestly, the less complicated answer is hit me up. You never know. And the worst case scenario, I'll refer you to somebody. Still warm in AM, I'm sorry. We had three iced teas, two finger iced teas, 101 proof. So I feel like my hand's doing pretty good for that. And then you just want to, like, basically subtly brighten these up with thin, with really watered down white. Thank you. just like that. Give ourselves a nice finish on that robe. Looking beast. You guys just need to get stockpiled before we do a show. Feel pretty good about where we're headed with this. Basically, what we're doing on this robe, we have to do on every part of her. Not just the robe, not just the purple stuff, but then we have to change colors, do the same thing. I mean, we have to bring this level to every part of her. We're gonna slide in there with a little bit of magenta still. I wanna tighten this up. Oh, fuck. We are getting a little ambitious. Might be fucking this up. Luckily, I can't fuck up a model enough not to be able to fix it. No matter how much iced tea I have. Says fine, I'll go now. Success. Clannix, how long did it take me to paint a mini this size? I mean, realistically, 12 hours. If I wasn't streaming it, 12 hours probably. Hours at the level that we're painting it. Like, if you're gonna try to do what we're doing here, yeah, like fucking every bit of 12 hours, homie. Retro Bot Prime, do you get bits when you donate? No, you get bits from Twitch. Or do I get them? Are you asking if I get them? I don't understand. Rephrase. Orc Pride, do you happen to talk while painting off stream? No, I listen to audiobooks. Like, I literally listen to audiobooks for 8 hours when I'm, you know, straight, right in a row. Right now I'm listening to Black Tower or Dark Tower series, Stephen King, Gunslinger series. I was listening to that motherfucker just paint all day, don't say a word. Audiobooks is literally where it's at, homie. It's part of my business expense. But yeah, there's that pink. You guys did a good job picking out that pink, man. Like, I think that pink is gonna come out fresh. I can't wait to see what it all looks like highlighted up. But real quick, let's do a quick little show and tell on our end. Okay, guys, today, because of you guys, we airbrushed all this pink and purple in, did some quick edge highlighting. But let me show you the rest of the story. Musafi, listen to Disturbed almost nonstop. Okay, this is the Beatle. And there's 1 minute left in the top donated giveaway that Sadak is all but guaranteed to win for the t-shirt. But this is the Beatle that this lady is going to ride. So she will be literally on top of this, if you guys don't know how this works. And this is the color palette. It is of all seasons. She's the Ever Queen. She ties in all the seasons. We worked on this base last week with you guys, having a lot of fun with this model. Oh, Rhino just checking in. We covered this base at the beginning. All the seasons, melting the snow away, revealing every season underneath as the Ever Queen. So if you guys don't know, this is what we're taking her to. She's going to ride this. Obviously, it's a showpiece for the army. Yeah, the Beetle Butt came out great, Shoggoth. And let's there it is. I've got a 30-second timer, arbitrary timer for to combat lag and donations. So Sadak made sure that no one could beat Sadak with the nail in the coffin. He's like, I will take home the last shirt of its kind. That's how Sadak do. Sadak is the winner. He says, thanks for bringing Javi back. You are the squanchies of them all. No, you are the squanchies of them all. Big shout out, Matt. Congratulations to my man, Sadak. The last of its kind. Tell us on the stream right now, Sadak. Do you want this shirt to be personalized? Do you want a signature on this shirt? And if you do, where do you want it in the shirt? How big do you want it? Let everyone know. Hoodsgate, I feel you. I want there to be some cherry blossoms on the base. I think I'm going to order some. But yeah, we worked on this base last stream. Showed you guys some technique. And this is where we're at with the base. She has every season. The theory is that she melted the snow away. As you can see, the realistic snow melts. And revealed the grass underneath and is blossoming the flowers. And of course, she's going to look like a beast on top. All right. Oz Pete got his signed. Sadak got his, is going to get his signed. And quick sneak peek, she's going to be riding on top of these branches, bringing all that heat. It's going to be out of control, guys. Let me show off one last thing, guys. Yo. Next month, in December, we are going to paint. We're going to be giving away this guy. I don't know when, but I know the first top donor giveaway of December will be the hoodie. The only hoodie of its kind. We'll be giving away the 3XL Always Keep It Icy hoodie, signed literally first Tuesday. But every stream in December, there's going to be six streams, guys. Six of them. Because I'm going on vacation. Every stream, we're going to give something away for free with a keyword raffle. Literally advent calendar style. So that's happening, guys. So we're going to give, he's going to be a top donor to give away. Hoodie, top donor to give away. But every stream, including the giveaway streams with the top donor to action, someone will walk home free with some swag, some minis, something. I got some Age of Sigmar minis, new in the sprue, and I've got some clutch Kromlik action, guys. We're going to be doing something every stream. You guys know what time it is. It's time for me to say thank you, guys. You guys are literally the greatest of all friends, holding it down on a Tuesday. Congratulations to Saldok. He won the charity gift bag. My man Slow Fuse. Big shout out to my man, the Great White Buffalo, for being the top cheer today. He's going to get a mystery gift bag. Don't forget to whisper me, Saldok. Don't forget to whisper me, Great White Buffalo. And you know, I'm part of the Brush Lickers United stream team. And so we're going to pass the torch off on this Tuesday to Michael Cho, who I believe is streaming right now, who is the leader of the Brush Lickers. And you guys know what we do. We're going to go in there. We're going to raid them. We're going to throw all of our Scary Terry emotes all over them, like we do. But don't forget, the Long War Network is coming to Twitch very soon. Find us on Facebook, guys. I want to see what you guys are working on. Much love. Next stream, I will pull the raffle. You have until tomorrow night to redeem your Yo Dogs. And then the stream is going to reset on the first. And we'll pull the raffle the very first stream. Love you guys.